Welcome to this tutorial on how to play the hard stuff by Justin Timberlake. We are in standard tuning. There's no capo. I'm not going to walk through the chords on this one. Just going to go over how to place your fingers and how the picking is going. And we're going to go through it nice and slow so we can all play along here. So, I start our index finger on this 4th fret of our G string. And we're going to play G, B, E. And the best way to do that with your fingers, I think, is to go with your middle finger on this G string, index finger on the B string, middle finger on the high E string, because you're going to be doing this a lot. We'll speed up to that here shortly, but so you do that, then you're going to place your ring finger on the 6th fret, play those same strings, so back to the 4th fret. That's the first part. So, and then from there, you're going to slide your index down to the 1st fret of that G, and your middle finger is going to go to the 2nd fret of the D string, which is one string up. And now your middle finger here is going to have to transition up to this D string. And we're going to play D, G, B, D. Okay, so stringing all that together, that sounds like this. And at full speed, that's what this sounds like. Okay, so that's the first part, and we'll revisit this all and play it all together at the end. But the second part is similar. We still go through the same thing. We go 4th fret, play those three strings, 6th fret, play those three strings, 4th fret, play those three strings. But now, instead of going back down here, we're going to leave our index finger on the 4th fret there, and we're going to stretch all the way up to the 7th fret here with our pinky on that D string. And now, again, instead of picking the G string with our thumb, we're going to pick the D string with our thumb. And we're going to go D, G, B strings. Okay, and you'll do that twice, so D, G, B, D, G, B. So that second part's really similar, it's just that one change, so. And at full speed here. Okay, now after you get to that point where you've played through this twice, you're gonna drop your pinky, put your ring finger here on the 6th fret of the D. We're gonna play D, G, B. Now this gets a little tricky here. We're gonna take both those fingers off. We're gonna move up to the 8th fret of the G with our ring finger. Play G, B, high E. Slide up to your 9th fret, G, B, high E, down to the 6th fret, G, B, high E, down to the 4th fret. Okay, so let's give that a little rhythm so you can hear how that's supposed to sound here. So stringing that together with the part we just learned. So that's how it's supposed to sound when you get the hang of it, but I know the picking's a little tricky. So let's go through it nice and slow here. Okay, so we're getting there, and then the last part, actually, it's the last part of the bar, but it's the first part that we played, so it's exactly the same as this. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and play through the whole thing here a couple times, and we're going to walk through nice and slow, because I know this is a lot to remember. So chorus to it. So that is what's played throughout the entire song. The tricky thing is really just getting your fingers here in that rhythm of G, B, E, G, B, E, and then switching to D, G, B, D, G, B. But I'm really just using these three fingers to do that. So that's where a lot of the practice is going to come in, and it'll take a little bit of time to get there. But that's going to be it for this tutorial. If you enjoyed this, please subscribe to my channel. I'd really appreciate that. For questions, comment below. Thank you for watching.